Have you ever heard about this term? I'm sure you have. Cultural imperialism. Imperialism, what is imperialism? Like you exercise your power over someone and you force them to do something. And that is what happened in colonialism period as well. You may have heard stories of what happened in Jallianwala Bagh incident. You may have heard that there was this incident that they there are many examples of imperialism, imperial rule in the subcontinent. So, but now that doesn't happen again in the form of geographical terms, but it does happen in the form of culture. What is cultural imperialism? Again, genes, is it prevalent dress? Even in non-Western societies, fast food concept, burgers and pizzas, it's not in an Asian, I mean on subcontinent concept. See, and similarly, the prevalence of Hollywood movies, Netflix, all these seasons like Game of Thrones, Stranger Things, and all of that. So this is cultural imperialism, like invasion is, cultural invasion is happening. We are being invaded, not geographically. It's not like American troops or Hollywood troops are coming or something like that, or soldiers are coming to invade us, but we are like mentally we are being invaded in terms of our culture. And there is another term that goes with it, cultural erosion. What is erosion? It happens usually in seashores. I mean, erosion, the piece of rock, it keeps shedding off. So culture is being eroded. Cultural erosion is happening, cultural imperialism. Increased cultural homogeneity. What is homogenous? You can understand homogenous in contrast to the word heterogeneous. If I say this class has heterogeneous group of people, it means heterogeneous people in terms of areas. This girl is from Gilgit-Baltistan, this girl is from Balochistan, this girl is from Karachi, she's from Sialkot, like that. This is a heterogeneous girl. Homogeneous is like same, yes. Like all of you are from Sialkot, that is a homogeneous group. So increased cultural homogeneity, like we see, I mean, again, genes may not be a specific way of dressing to a particular area, it's now global. It's a dress that is worn globally. Increased cultural homogeneity. Again, we can think about it in the form of media consumption, food consumption, and so many other things. Loss of national and regional identities. We have talked about, I mean, in Pakistan, there are these debates happening that regional languages are dying. Like many Pakistan, like Brohi, Kashmiri, and many other languages. Now, the people who use this language or literally speak this language, they are shrinking. And this is what is happening as a result of cultural imperialism. And English, I mean, this is again related to the idea of power. English is a powerful language because it is spoken by people who have power politically, geographically, socially, economically, and all these respects. I'll stop here this lecture now. We have learned a lot about international communication.